you know, I was always drumming on everything on the kitchen table at night, you know. So that's when I started drumming.
We sing about beauty and we sing about truth at $10,000 a show.
Right.
We take all kind of pills to give us all kind of thrills, but the thrill we never know is the thrill that'll get you when you get your picture on the cover of the Rolling Stone.
My name is Jay David. That's what people know me as. My real given name is John Michael Thomas David. I was the staff drummer at Mercury Records in New York City, so I was playing on all of the demos and some of the hits that were coming out and in those days. And this producer played me a tape of this group called Dr. Hook and the Medicine Show, singing a song that Shel Silverstein wrote called The Last Morning. And I heard a lead singer, Dennis, and I said, I gotta work with that guy. Great, great, great voice.
This is the last morning.
I went in, sat in with the guys, and we became fast friends, and I was sitting with them at night after I got out of the studio. And the producer that played me that tape is the guy that introduced us all to Shel Silverstein.
Little something.
Yeah, like what?
What do you do? Like to put up in my vein one more
round. His mother sold 5 million. It went to number one, and it was our first single. Mrs. Avery, I just gotta talk to her. I'll only keep her a while.
For a while.
Says Sylvia's packing, she's gone, believe.
Shel called us up one night. We were on a road and he said, how'd you guys like to get on the cover of the Rolling Stone? We said, well, that sounds like fun. So he then sang the song to us and on the telephone, and we went and worked it out. And then when we went when we came off the road, we went right into the studio and recorded it.
Wanna see my smiling babe on the cover of the Rolling Stone. On the cover of the Rolling Stone.
Wanna see my picture on the
Stone.
I'm 5 copies for my album.
Stone.
Wanna see my smiling babe
on the cover of the Rolling Stone.
Five plane ride day. Five plane rides from Fargo, North Dakota to Dallas. And I drank more than I should have and gotten into an argument with Dennis and said, I'm going home. And I did. And they were mad at me. They may still be mad at me. I don't know. It's okay. It's all good, you know. I was not a nice man to be around. I was getting high. I had other things to do, other things to spend time doing, and I was not a nice guy, and sex, drugs, and rock and roll, and just because I had a family, I didn't let any of that get in the way of sex, drugs, and rock and roll.
Jay's from
we haven't even
New Jersey.
New Jersey, huh?
Bayonne.
I was talking to some young lady on the telephone one night, and she said, I heard her yelling, Jay, shut up. You've been talking straight for 2 hours. You haven't even stopped to breathe. You're an addict. And nobody ever called me that before, but I found myself saying, yes, I am. So I came down from Sonoma County down to LA the next day to go into rehab. I did a solo album. It's called This Road. It's wonderful to be able to record an album in your home studio, which is what I did, and polish it off in a regular studio, and then offer it up to people, and I can sell my albums all over the world. And it's truly taking, it's still growing. Maybe it'll always grow. It's taken on a life of its own. And so I was really just another casualty, really. And I knew I had a center of integrity someplace in me, but I didn't, until I got sober, until I worked these steps, until I realized that I could choose a higher power of my own understanding. No time for sorrow. Here in my heart, I guess there's no time for sorrow. No time for sorrow.